I'm going to move on to the top load bobbin, because after I show you how to load a top load bobbin, after that they're basically the same. On a top load bobbin, Chris, you have that graphic
here? Yep.
So on the top of the machine that has, on the bed of the machine that is a top load bobbin, you'll almost always see a variation of this graphic. And this graphic, the way it's pointing is the way you want your thread to pull off of the bobbin. And while it seems silly and small, it's absolutely crucial. If it's in there and it's pulling clockwise, because that's counterclockwise, if it's pulling clockwise, you're gonna have tangles underneath your needle and it's not gonna wanna grab. So always, if the sticker is missing off of your machine, feel free to print this and have it handy and stick it somewhere on your machine, because this one is going to be crucial. So when you set your bobbin in, it's easy to see how you set it in as far as going counterclockwise. And in that graphic, you can see that there's a little finger that sticks out on the bottom, and it's shaped like a like an index finger, making a C shape right here.
Right here?
Right there. So you're actually gonna slip the thread underneath that, and you pull, and you'll hear just a gentle click. So I'll try to show you on this one.
So let me stop the share. So,
yeah.
Okay, back to you.
Yeah, let me see if I can pull forward so you can see it a little bit better. So as you're doing this, it's going to slide under that finger, and then you're going to hear a very subtle click as it engages. And so now it's engaged, and that's it. This one's done. This is a lot easier on your hands and dexterity, and for little fingers and old fingers. Top load bobbins makes life a lot easier.